What we're going to look at in this example is a binary phase diagram where we take a liquid and cool it down to form a solid. And we're going to, in this case, look at alloy of antimony and bismuth. There are other videos that describe the equilibrium behavior, but what we want to look at is the non-equilibrium behavior. In reality, because the fusion is slow in solids, we don't always get the equilibrium behavior. And so what we're going to describe here is what would happen under more realistic, practical rates of cooling to form a solid from a liquid. And this has a significant effect on then the subsequent properties of the solid that forms, so it's important to understand these differences. So we're looking at the same phase diagram that is also described in another video. High temperature, we have a liquid. Low temperature, a solid solution. This is the mole fraction of bismuth. And we're going to look at starting with a liquid at 60%, bismuth at a temperature around 550 degrees centigrade. Keep in mind, over here is the melting point for bismuth, and then here is the melting point for antimony. So to make it easier to visualize, what we're going to do is look at a blow up of this center section. And we're just looking at just this region. So here we're starting with a liquid. We're going to cool it down. This region is solid. The region in between is the two-phase region, right? So the liquid plus solid coexist in that region. And so when we cool it to this point, what I've drawn here is just a tie line that this is the solid phase that is in equilibrium with the liquid phase. So liquid composition, mole fraction of bismuth of 0.6. The solid composition, approximately 0.22. So solid and liquid have significantly different compositions. This would be the equilibrium. So the first solid that forms would have this composition. And what we would end up with is a mixture of liquid and small particles of the solid that are forming. And so I've just represented this where the yellow represents the liquid and the black then is the solid composition of 0.22 mole fraction of bismuth. So this is equilibrium. This is the first solid. We're saying this is equilibrium. However, now as we continue to cool, what happens is going to end up being non-equilibrium because we cannot cool it slow enough in typical operations. We're cooling it too fast for solid diffusion to keep up. So let's look as we get down to a point here. Remember, this point where I've drawn the X is the overall composition. The overall composition is 60% bismuth, but it consists of a liquid and a solid. So I've drawn another tie line because equilibrium, the phases are at the same temperature, so have to be in a horizontal line. The mole fraction now of the liquid is increased because we're forming something that's enriched in bismuth. And this is the mole fraction, 0.32, of the solid that forms at this temperature. That's the equilibrium value. However, when this happens, the solid that had already formed doesn't immediately mix and have rapid diffusion, so we form a solid around these solid particles. So I very schematically represented this, where again, this is a cross-section. This yellow now is the liquid. Its composition is 0.74. These little green sections, since we have this core shell structure, so little green sections where we're making approximations to visualize this, their composition is 0.32, but we still have this other solid inside with 0.22. Well, in reality, now as we continue to cool, it's a gradient and layered upon layered structure, so it's a continuous change. But Louise, you just represent it this way, and then we keep building more shells around as we cool further down. But this means since we have solid with a mole fraction of 0.22 and solid with a mole fraction of 0.32, the average is somewhere in between. This is a volume average, so it's certainly closer to the 0.32. So that means our non-equilibrium, our overall composition of the solid, is here, somewhere lower than this equilibrium line, because it's some average of these values of the different solids that form. And what this means when we look at the lever rule, now we actually have more liquid than we would have if we were at equilibrium. And so as we cooled, there's some continuous line of this non-equilibrium, and the non-equilibrium continues. This is just a schematic representation. So this also means that when we get to this point, we have some overall average solid composition, equilibrium with this liquid. But unlike equilibrium case, we have not formed all solid. In equilibrium case, this would all be solid. Instead, we have a mixture of a solid and a liquid. So when we get to this point where we have all solid, I've tried to just schematically represent, but we have a bunch of regions with a gradient. So we have this core structure with shells of different continuous changes in composition. So I've just tried to schematically represent that. And these different regions have different melting points, which means one, when we start raising the temperature, we're going to melt the regions between the particles first and have a solid and liquid region. We're not going to melt it uniformly. So some important aspects: we have a non-uniform distribution, which is referred to as segregation. We have this core structure. We're quite different from the equilibrium composition, where the equilibrium, these regions will be of uniform composition, but they're not because diffusion is slow. So different from equilibrium. And we said diffusion is slow in the solid. Note, however, we assume diffusion is fast enough in the liquid that we maintain the liquid composition here, because diffusion indeed is much faster in the liquid, but diffusion is slower in the solid, so our overall composition is going to be different from what we expect from the equilibrium phase diagram. So the center, the black dots represented here, have higher melting points than the grain boundaries, the region between these distinct. And the final thing is the details of what this line looks like, this non-equilibrium line, is going to be a function of how fast we cool the liquid. So if we cool really slow, we're going to be closer to the equilibrium line. If we cool fast, we're going to be further from the equilibrium line. Keep in mind, the important point here is that this affects the structure of the solid when it's not uniform, but has a gradient of concentrations.